Hi everyone, it's Bianca here. Let's make an courgette candle cozy. What we need for this project, a candle. And this candle smells delicious. It burns about 40 hours and I buy it by the IKEA. So we need also yarn. I use yarn from Stonewashed from Scheepjes. You can choose any color that you want. We need for this yarn a 3 or 3.5 millimeter crochet hook. I use a 3.5 millimeter crochet hook. You need also a scissor and a needle. Let's get started. Round one, and I pull here on the easy start of the middle of the ball. Cut off that little marker here, that little sticker, and then we make a magic circle on the hook. Like this, and now we can start. We make one chain, counts for nothing. Then here in the magic circle, make 6 single crochets in total. Enter your hook in that magic circle, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull the 2, that's 1. Back in that same circle, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull the 2. That's 2, again, that's 3, 4, 5, and 6. 6 single crochets in the magic circle. Now you pull on that short tail to close the magic circle. And now we close this first round with a slip stitch on the top of the first single crochet. Here in the beginning you work 1 chain stitch, counts for nothing. You go under through that V on the top of the first chain, the first single crochet, yarn over, pull through and pull through to make that slip stitch. Round 2, we're going to increase single crochets. We start with a chain, counts for nothing. Now here in that same stitch where you close with a slip stitch in the previous round, you work 2 single crochets in that same stitch. On the top, that's 1, back into that same stitch for a second. 2 single crochets in that same stitch. Go to the next stitch, make 2 single crochets in that stitch. It's 1 and 2. Also 2 single crochets into the next stitch. 1 and 2. We do this 3 more times. Into the next stitch, 2 single crochets. 2 single crochets in the next stitch and 2 single crochets in the last stitch here. So we have all the way around now 12 single crochets in total. Now we skip here the chain stitch and then on the top of the wheel first single crochet, go under to that V and make 1 slip stitch. Round 3, we work at the same way that we did in the previous round. We increase stitches. We begin with a chain count for knotting. Back in that same stitch where you make in the previous round, that slip stitch, make 2 single crochets in that same stitch. It's 1 and 2. Skip over to the next stitch, make also 2 single crochets in that same stitch. And this is the way how we work all the way around. Make all the way around in every stitch 2 single crochets. On the end of this round you have 24 single crochets in total. Twenty-four single crochets in total all the way around. Now we skip here also that first chain stitch, count for knotting, then under through that V-stitch of the top of the first single crochet, you work 1 slip stitch. Round 4. Make a chain. Now back in that same stitch of the previous round where you make that slip stitch, make 2 single crochets into that same stitch. 1 and 2. Now in the next 3 stitches, make only 1 single crochet. It's 1 into the next stitch, 2 into the next stitch, and 3. The repeat of this round. Into the next stitch, make 2 single crochets in that same stitch, 1 and 2, and then in the next 3 stitches only 1 single crochet. It's 1 in the next, 2 in the next, 3. Work like this all the way around. In the next stitch you work 2 single crochets in the same stitch, and then in the next 3 stitches only 1 single crochet. If you all the way around, you have 30 stitches in total, and we close on the top of the first single crochet with a slip stitch. Round 5. Start with a chain count for knotting. Now back in that same stitch, make 1 single crochet. Also in the next 2 stitches, make 1 single crochet. 1 into the next stitch, also 1. So we have here a chain and then 3 single crochets. Now into the next stitch, we make 2 single crochets in that same stitch. 1, back in that same stitch for a second. Now make a single crochet in the next 4 stitches. It's 1 into the next, 2 in the next, 3 in the next, 4. Into the next stitch, make 2 single crochets in that same stitch. Into the next 4 stitches, 1 single crochet. It's 1, 2, 3 and 4. In the next stitch, an increase of 2 single crochets in that same stitch. Into the next 4 stitches, 1 single crochet. Then in the next stitch, 2 single crochets in that same stitch. And then in the next 4 stitches, 1 single crochet. Into the next stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And then in the next 4 stitches, only 1 single crochet. Now we work an increase of 2 single crochets into the next stitch. and then in the last stitch you work only one single crochet. Close with a slip stitch on the top of the first single crochet, and now you have all the way around 36 stitches in total. Round 6, start with a chain, counts for nothing, back in that same stitch with an increase of 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And then into the next 5 stitches, make 1 single crochet. It's 2, 3, 4, and 5. And this is also the repeat you work all the way around. 4 more times, into the next stitch, 2 single crochets. In that same stitch, and then in the next 5 stitches only 1 single crochet. All the way around, make a slip stitch on the top of the first single crochet, and then you have 42 stitches in total. In this round we make double crochets in every stitch, not through that whole stitch, but only in the back loop of the stitch. We start with a chain 3, counts for a first double crochet. Now yarn over, enter your hook into the next stitch, not through that whole stitch of the V. This is the front loop, and this here is the back loop, and only in the back loop. Go in with your hook and make 1 double crochet in that stitch. Yarn over, enter your hook in the next stitch only in the back loop and make 1 double crochet. Yarn over into the next back loop and double crochet. So we work all the way around. In every stitch, 1 double crochet only in the back loop, and you see here that nice little stitches here on the front, and that's what we want. I have to make 1 more last stitch only in the back loop, then we close with a slip stitch here on the top of the first double crochet, and that's the chain 3 in the third chain stitch with a slip stitch. In this round we make V stitches all the way around. We start with the first double crochet, and that's a chain 3. Then we have to make a chain stitch. Make 1 more chain, so we have 4 chain stitches. The first 3 chain stitches counts for a double crochet, and the 4th chain stitch is a chain stitch. Back into that same stitch, make 1 more double crochet. This is the first V stitch. Now yarn over, skip the next 2 stitches, and then in the next stitch make 1 double crochet, chain 1, 1 double crochet, back in that same stitch for another V stitch. And this is the way how we work all the way around. Yarn over, skip the next 2 stitches, into the next stitch, new V stitch of 1 double crochet, chain 1, 1 double crochet in the same stitch. Work like this all the way around, and then we close here on the top of the third chain stitch with a slip stitch. And all the way around with all the V stitches. Then on the end we have 2 stitches left over. We skip those 2 stitches, close with a slip stitch on the top of the third chain stitch with a slip stitch. Start with a slip stitch in the first space of the first V-stitch. Make a chain 4. This counts for a double crochet and a chain 1. Back in that same V-stitch, make 1 double crochet. So we have a new V-stitch in the V-stitch here below. Yarn over, enter yoke in the next V-stitch in the chain 1 space and make a new V-stitch. Double crochet, chain 1, double crochet, back in that same stitch. And this is the way how we work all the way around. Yarn over, into the next V-stitch, a new V-stitch. 1 double crochet, chain 1, 1 double crochet. All the way around and close also with a slip stitch here in the beginning on the top of the first double crochet in the third chain stitch. Skip over to the first V stitch, make a slip stitch in that V. And we start all over again. Make a chain 3 for first double crochet and one more chain stitch. Back in that same V stitch and double crochet for a first V stitch. Yarn over, enter yoke in the next V stitch, work a new V stitch, 1 double crochet, chain 1, 1 double crochet. All the way around and close with a slip stitch here on the top of the first double crochet in the third chain stitch. In this round we make all the way around double crochets on top of each double crochet and in every chain 1 space. We start with the first chain 3. That's our first double crochet. And we made that first double crochet on top of the first double crochet of that first V-stitch. 1 double crochet in that chain 1 space of the V-stitch. And 1 double crochet on the second double crochet of the V-stitch. These 3 stitches we work all the way around. A double crochet on the top of the first double crochet of the V. Then a double crochet in the chain 1 space of the V. And a double crochet on the second double crochet of the V. 3 double crochets on top of every V-stitch, on the top of the double crochet, in the chain 1 space, on the top of the next double crochet. Work like this all the way around and then we close also with a slip stitch here in the beginning on the top of the third chain stitch. The final round. We start with a chain, counts for nothing, it's only to high up a stitch. Now back into that same stitch where you make that slip stitch in the previous round, make 1 single crochet in that stitch. Now on top of every double crochet, make 1 single crochet all the way around. Make all your stitches. And then in the beginning we make an invisible join to close this last round. I'm all the way around, make all my single crochets. Now we cut the yarn and open up that last single crochet stitch. Pull your hook all the way up and then with the needle. We go to the second stitch. We skip always that first stitch, that's the first single crochet here. Here we have made that chain stitch counts for nothing. We skip that also. Dus we skip that first stitch, we go to the second single crochet. Now here on the top, under to that V, on the front to the back, pull through. And then you work here on the top of the last single crochet, only in the back loop. On top, then pull through. This is your invisible join here. So we make a little knot on the inside of our work. Make a little loop. And make a little knot. So wave that tail in. And skip one thread here on the back. And go to the other side and work only in the back of the stitches. Be sure that you see not that needle on the front. And pull through. Now here in the inside we have here the tail of the magic circle. Pull to close that circle, make a little knot and wave also in the back loop of the stitches this tail. Are you here for the first time? Then please subscribe to my channel. Click on the bell so you don't miss any new videos from me. Thank you for watching and I hope to see you next time. Bye!